In this video, we're going to show you how the retargeting LUT feature works inside CalMAN. As you can tell, it looks like we've just calibrated a display. We made a 3D LUT for a broadcast monitor in the .cube format for DaVinci Resolve. And now we're going to go ahead and use the retargeting LUT feature to output a different LUT based on the profile that we've already made on the display. Now, to use the retargeting feature, you're going to want to select the cube generator drop-down tab, and down in the left corner you'll see it says retarget LUT from profile. I'm going to go ahead and select that. Select a profile that we just made, and I'll open it. It's going to load that characterization of the display and bring up a list of options so that I can create a new output LUT. Inside this pop-up window, I have the option to choose different file formats. So we just made one for Resolve, but let's say I've added an AJ LUT box and I want to make this file work for the LUT box. I could then select that format. Or perhaps I'm using this LUT for a different software application. Rather than remeasuring thousands of points on the display, I can just use the profile I made to output another LUT file. And so you would select the file format here, the output cube size, bit depth. Here's where you would change the name and location of where the new LUT would go. If for some reason you wanted to output different LUT formats, so let's say you characterized the display, you calibrated it, created a LUT, and it was for D65 HD Rec.709, but you also wanted to have one for DCI-P3 color space with a slightly different white point and gamma. What you could simply do is just select that in this drop-down, D-Cinema, Power Formula 2.6. You click OK. The software will generate the new LUT based on the profile that you already took when CalMAN was taking thousands of color point readings of your display. It's already created this characterization. So now it's just going to, based on all it learned about the display, it can recreate another file type based on all these configurations. And like I said, this is useful for a couple different things. If you're loading a LUT now into a display, and you previously were using it for Resolve and software, maybe using it for a LUT box, or maybe you just want to create multiple LUTs at different standards or different gamma formulas. So it's a handy little thing you can do, saves you a ton of time. You don't have to re-characterize the display with thousands of readings. And if I wanted, I could go back now, use that LUT in either a display, the software, or external inline LUT box.